Welcome back, Bice, to the sixth week of our Enneagram in You session for CEU and our fifth Enneagram type today. So we get to talk about the investigator today. And you can find the notes underneath the video on YouTube, and you can follow along with us using those notes. And I also just want to say welcome to all our many viewers. So, I mean, we're a worldwide audience, and so we just feel really blessed to all our viewers today. So I hope that everybody enjoys today's session, and we can go ahead and get started. So as I said, the five is the investigator. And today we're going to look through Thomas's life as the Bible figure that represents a five. Our Bible reference is Deuteronomy 6:4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. And then, as our purpose has been for all the others, we're just going to better understand the investigator, their strengths, weaknesses, and different communication styles. So let's go ahead and dig in to the Enneagram Type 5. The Enneagram Type 5 is called the investigator. The Type 5s are very wise. I've also heard them say they are the wise number. And so I think that that is a really good word to describe them. And the fives that I know in my life definitely are people who are wise and have given me a lot of wisdom during kind of difficult times or different problems that I am personally struggling with. So I think that is definitely one of the best strengths of a five, is just their wisdom. They often are described as very perceptive, informed, introverted, and sometimes can be detached. And so I think what the positives that you can really see in this is that they're very perceptive. They see things that people wouldn't necessarily see before. They are people who are going to want to figure out the why to a question and figure out the answer. They won't just take, well, this is fact. They want to know why, and they want to investigate it for themselves. They often can be kind of introverted, and I think usually kind of because they really do want to grow in knowledge. And so a lot of times they're reading or they're doing some activities that you kind of do more by yourself. And I think sometimes high social interactions can be draining for a five, that they feel overwhelmed or, it's just like too much people around. So they definitely have to take their time to be have their alone time, and they definitely usually are introverted. So the besetting sin, and we can remember from the past weeks that our besetting sin is just a constant problem or kind of something that maybe they have struggled with, that they can fall easily into struggling with. And sometimes fives can really fall into greed, not necessarily in greed in the way we would necessarily think, but greed in that they kind of keep to themselves, that they kind of, they really enjoy time by themselves, that they really enjoy kind of keeping sometimes even their knowledge to themselves. And so I think what's hard for a five is to really open up and kind of be able to be vulnerable or be able to share time or knowledge. I think oftentimes they can kind of just want to keep it to themselves because that is what's most comfortable for them. And so they're kind of, not like greedy with their time or kind of specific about how they're going to spend their time and what they're going to do. So that can kind of be something that fives can fall into and kind of get stuck and not really jump out of their comfort zones. And then the underlying emotion that fives can often kind of fall into is fear of rejection, fear that people won't think they're smart, fear that they're wrong. I think fives really value knowledge and really value what is right and true. And so they have a fear if they are wrong, then that kind of hits their identity or purpose in a hard way. So fives can often kind of fall into that fear of rejection or fear of being wrong. And sometimes, as I said before, like some of the social interactions can sometimes be hard and draining. And oftentimes they kind of do prefer to be more introverted. And so I think there's also this deep kind of fear of rejection because some social situations can be kind of hard to navigate as a five, and so they have a fear that people aren't going to like them or that they will be rejected by people. And so fives often believe that they must be knowledgeable and equipped. So they want to have the information, they want to know the information, they want to know what is expected of them. And they also want to have the tools in order to be able to do it. So if someone said, go do this, and there was no background knowledge, there's no help or resources, a five would really struggle. They really want to be knowledgeable, know about a certain topic or something, and then be equipped to also do it. So when you're kind of interacting with a five, I think it's important to know that they want to know why, but they also kind of need to be equipped in order to be able to kind of move forward in whatever the knowledge is. So, Jason's going to come up and talk about Thomas and some of the more spiritual formations of a five.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Kristen, for helping us to investigate the investigator. What fun this is. As Krista mentioned, the biblical example or character that we'd like to give for the five is Thomas. Now, sometimes Thomas is referred to, right, as Doubting Thomas. And we all know the story very well. After Jesus died on the cross and rose from the grave, he appeared to the ladies at the tomb. He appeared to the other disciples. But Thomas wasn't quite believing this because he wasn't in one of those groups that had had a personal interaction with the risen Savior yet. So when the other disciples begin to report this to Thomas, that Jesus had in fact risen, just as he said, Thomas was having a hard time believing this. Now, let's remember that for over the last 3 years, that these are people that Thomas had done life and ministry with on every level. Like these are people that he should knew were people of their word. Like they trusted Jesus, they followed Jesus. This would be a really bad trick to play on one of your closest friends to tell them that your greatest hope had come true, that Jesus had indeed been risen from the grave. So everything would point us to believing that Thomas should have accepted this story from the other disciples at face value, that he should have said, yes, if you say it, I believe it. Right? But he didn't, and he couldn't, and he said, unless I see with my eyes, I won't believe that Jesus is actually risen. And so we, of course, know the story that Jesus appears, presents himself to Thomas. Thomas puts his hands in the nail prints of Jesus' hands, and he believes. And that is the five, right? They need to sort of touch the nail prints for themselves. They need to be able to explore and figure out for themselves, just like Thomas. Fives are prone, as Kristen said, to envy or to greed that is motivated by some underlying fear of in their lives. So, in terms of spiritual formation for a five. We need to understand that the Spirit of Christ wants to transform that spirit of envy or greed in their life into love, peace, and generosity. And he wants that in the life of a five. Now, there are some spiritual strengths that five has, and I think there's a lot of strengths that fives have. But on in terms of like the daily disciplines of our walk, some things that come easier to a five would be like Bible study or reading books. For instance, with Bible study, sort of examining scriptures on a deeper level is something that a five would be passionate about. Understanding the who, what, when, where, and why is something they would dig into. I think of Lee Strobel, who was at one time an atheist, but he as a reporter or a journalist began to examine Christ. And actually came to faith as he was examining the claims of Christ. And we, of course, would know him from books like The Case for Christ or The Case for Easter. Fives dig in when it comes to Bible study and are studying the scripture or scriptural principles. Now, some challenges that they might have, and remember, when we say challenges, it isn't that all fives will struggle with these. It's just perhaps disciplines in the faith that might not come as easy for a five. Now, you might know some people that are fives that do these things really well, and that's because over the course of their life, they've just cultivated the discipline of these things maybe differently than another five has. But these are just perhaps some challenges that a five might have. Things like sharing could be difficult for a five. Fives would prefer to remain inside their own heads, right, and withhold themselves from others. And so giving of themselves freely, giving of the information they have freely to others might be hard. So it's something that they have to work on, sharing themselves or sharing their feelings with others is sometimes difficult. Serving at times can be difficult for some fives because fives can tend to be somewhat introverted, and they have to learn to get out of their bubble. Now, they many times love people and are compassionate towards people, but serving people can sometimes be hard because it causes them to be around people. Now, fives at their worst can become reclusive and isolated from others, maybe even isolated from reality at times. And that's sort of a grim picture. But fives at their best can become visionaries who find entirely new ways of doing things or perceiving things. And they are some pretty great people when operating at that level. Now, the biblical reference we gave for this is Deuteronomy 6:4. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. This verse reminds us that as human beings, we are made to worship God with our whole selves. Remember, we are made in the image of God. And God is saying, Hear, O Israel, the Lord is one. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, right? That's what we would know in terms of this scripture. The Lord is one, right? And we are made in His image. Because we are made in His image, we are one in our body, in our mind, and in our spirit. And it's important that we engage both our emotions, both our physical bodies, and our spirit in a way that honors God. We're not just minds, all right? We're just not gaining information, but we use that information to engage the body and the spirit as well. So that's the five. We want to pray for you, and we want to pray that God would help us. Remember, we are all a little bit, at least, of all of these things. So all of us have some of this five in us if we're not fully a five. So all of us have some of those questions and things that times that we have. And we want to engage with those questions like Thomas had. So let's pray for the five inside of all of us, and especially for the fives out there, that God would help us to be that best version of ourselves. Let's pray. God, we love you and we thank you that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. And we do pray for the investigators today, Lord, those fives that you have put this this desire to know things and to Lord, to just dig a little deeper than the surface will sometimes offer. We pray, Lord, that you would help them to be that best version of themselves, never sinking into that place of being reclusive, but always, Lord, using the desires that you've put inside of them to be that person that will open up new possibilities and new ways of doing things. God, I pray that you would help us all to with the same advice you gave Thomas. Blessed are those who believe without seeing. God, even when we want all of the answers and they seem to be lacking, let us still fully put our trust in you and believe even when we can't see. We love you and we thank you for this in your strong name. Amen. Bless you guys. Hope you have a great day.